بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. All praise due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him, we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. The brothers and sisters, have you ever seen a king who was suffering from thirst and hunger and left without any food or drink? Have you ever seen a king who was suffering or afflicted with many diseases and left without any medicine or treatment? Have you ever seen a king who was left neglected and disregarded? It is extremely difficult and impossible to find a king with such criteria. But I can assure you today that we have many of those kings amongst us. One of them could be within our bodies, inside us, living within ourselves. Did you realize what I mean? It is your heart. It is my heart. The heart is the master of all the limbs. In fact, it is the king of all the limbs. And if the heart is upright, righteous, and sound, then the entire body will become upright, righteous, and sound. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, one of the companions, said, "The heart is the king, and the body parts are his soldiers." And if the king is upright and righteous, then the entire body will be upright and righteous. But if the king is corrupt, then the entire body will be corrupt and infected. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Each part of our body has a job with which it worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. The ear worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by listening to that which is good. The good words, the Quran, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the tongue worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by uttering the good words, by uttering the beloved words to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by reciting the Quran, by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. And the eye worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by lowering the gaze and looking and reflecting upon the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what is the job of the heart? What is the job of the heart? The job of the heart is to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Him and rely upon Him. And you might ask, why should we investigate our hearts? Why do we need to check our hearts and investigate our hearts? We do that because the heart is the place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, looks at. Allah will not look at your face or your outer appearance or your body or your muscles or your tribe or your color or your nationality or your background. Allah ta'ala will not look at anything but your heart and your actions. Subhanallah, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "For indeed, inna Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum wala ila wujuhikum." That indeed Allah ta'ala does not look at your faces or your body parts. Allah ta'ala, but He looks at your hearts. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ أَجْسَامِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ. But He looks at your hearts وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. And He, صلى الله عليه وسلم, pointed with His blessed finger to His chest. So that's why we have to look after our heart. We have to investigate our heart. We have to check that is our heart, the place that Allah Ta'ala, the Almighty, looks at, must be at its highest standard, at his best standard. Secondly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order for the heart to be purified. Allah ta'ala, the Almighty, made this one of the most important tasks upon the prophets. It even comes before teaching the people the Quran and the Sunnah. Before you learn the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran, the Sunnah, the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your heart must be receptive to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah ta'ala, the Quran said,
هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who sent amongst the illiterate people, the illiterate people, a messenger from themselves. Doing what?
رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم.
Reciting upon them his verses, his revelation, and purifying their hearts. And then after that,
وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ.
After purifying their hearts, then teaching them the Quran and the Sunnah, because their hearts must be receptive to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The heart must be ready for Allah's revelation. So the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Anbiya before him, they do their best to ensure that our hearts are receptive to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by helping us in purifying our hearts, in cleansing our hearts, in making our hearts submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in making our hearts dedicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. We investigate our hearts because most of the problems, disputes, conflicts, fights amongst the people, their source is the heart. Most of the evil actions that will throw us in the hellfire, their source is the heart. Hypocrisy is from the heart. Showing off is from the heart. Belittling people, deriding people is from the heart. Hatred is from the heart. Doubt is from the heart. And also lack of hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from the heart. Jealousy is from the heart. Envy is from the heart. Accusation of lie is from the heart. Belying the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from the heart. Most of the evil actions, most of the evil deeds that will cause Allah's anger upon us and cause Allah's wrath upon us, their source is the heart. And on the other hand, most of the righteous deeds, the good actions that will elevate us in the highest ranks of Jannah, their source is the heart. Subhanallah. Iman is from the heart. In fact, the heart is the container of Iman. Sincerity is from the heart. Loving Allah Ta'ala is from the heart. Fearing Allah Ta'ala, the Almighty, is from the heart. Piety, taqwa, is from the heart. Reliance upon Allah Ta'ala, tawakkul, is from the heart. Hope in Allah Ta'ala is from the heart. Certainty, one of the righteous actions and deeds, is from the heart. That's why we must investigate our hearts. Most of the righteous actions that will enable us to attain the highest ranks of Jannah, their source is the heart. And that's why the people, or the knowledgeable people, the scholars who know Allah Ta'ala the most, they always invoke Allah Ta'ala. They always supplicate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with an important things. They say that we may afford the trial of the body. If we have a disease, if we have an affliction, if we have anything in our body, we may afford that. But the disease of the heart is so difficult. If the heart is corrupt, it's so difficult that you get the heart upright again. They always ask Allah Ta'ala and they say,
رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِقْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا.
Oh Allah, don't cause our hearts to go astray after you have guided us.
رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِقْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إنك أنت الوهاب.
Oh Allah, give us a mercy from you. You are the all-giving. Subhanallah. All of these points confirms one important fact. And that is, the heart is the most important part of our body. And we must take great care of it. As we take great care of our bodies, we must take a great care of our hearts. We must make sure that we always look after our hearts by purifying it, by ensuring that the heart is always submitted to Allah Ta'ala, the Almighty Subhanahu Azza wa Jal. The brothers and sisters, in a summary, nothing will benefit you, nothing will avail you, nothing will be of most important on the Day of Judgment more than meeting Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala with a righteous heart, with a good heart, with a sound heart. And Allah Ta'ala in the Quran told us this.
يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون.
On that day, neither your wealth or your children will be of any benefit.
إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم.
Except for the one who came to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a sound heart. Allahu Akbar. So we must make sure that our hearts is always ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always ask yourself, is my heart ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do I have something in my heart that I cannot meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with? Do I have hatred in my heart against the believers? Do I have envy in my heart against the believers? Do I have jealousy? Do I have lack of hope in Allah Ta'ala? Do I have lack of reliance upon Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? Do I have lack of fear of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? Do I have lack of love to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? Make sure that your heart is always ready. And let me ask a question. What type of heart do you have? What type of heart do you possess? The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us the types of hearts. And he said in the sound hadith that Muslim narrated, he said, temptations, meaning sins, will be exposed to the hearts one after another. Meaning that in every stage of your life, you will have a chance to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will have an opportunity to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way how you react towards them will determine the type of heart that you will have. Then he said, any heart that accepts these temptations, a black spot will be placed on the heart. A mark that is black, a black stain will be placed on the heart. And any heart that rejects them, a mark of purity or a white spot will be placed on the heart. Until hearts become of two types. A dark heart that has turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and became like the overturned vessel, turned upside down, and this heart does not know or recognize any good or forbid any evil except that which suits its own whims and desires. Subhanallah. Because this heart, it turns upside down. This heart cannot hold any guidance. This heart cannot receive any guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For it to receive guidance, it must return back upright. And then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and the other heart, the second type of hearts, is a pure and white heart. Pure, white, like the marble, strong. And this heart, no further temptation will harm it as long as the heaven and the earth exist. Why? Subhanallah. Because this heart has rejected these sins, the temptations of shaitan, and relied upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, Allah ta'ala will increase this heart in guidance. Allah ta'ala will keep this heart strong and Allah Ta'ala will grant steadfastness. As Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said,
وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ.
Those who sought guidance and walk aright, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase them in guidance. زَادَهُمْ هُدًى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ. Allah ta'ala will grant them piety. Subhanallah. It begins from you. You seek guidance, you walk aright, you offer Allah's obligations, Allah ta'ala will increase you in guidance. Allah ta'ala will keep you firm on the straight path. The brothers and sisters, Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah's mercy be upon him, mentioned the types of hearts. And he said, the hearts are of three types. He derived these sections or types from the hadith. And he said, the first type of hearts is the dark and empty of iman heart. The heart that has no iman, has no faith, and is dark and overturned like the overturned vessel. It's turned upside down, subhanAllah. He said, this heart, the shaitan is in rest of whispering to it. Why? Because the shaitan is living inside it. SubhanAllah. So there is no need for the shaitan to whisper to this heart. So the shaitan is living and residing inside this heart. There is no need for whispering. The second type of hearts is the heart that has some iman, and at the same time, it has some sins. So it has some brightness of the iman, and he has some darkness of the sins. So the shaitan and the owner of this heart are always fighting each other. And the war between them is in a constant manner. And this heart is at a great risk, subhanAllah, or in a great risk. May Allah Ta'ala guide us. Many of us have this type of heart. The third type of heart is the heart that is filled with iman, subhanAllah. And this iman has a brightness, Allahu Akbar. And this brightness will burn the shaitan if the shaitan attempts to come near to this heart, subhanAllah. And Ibn Qayyim said, the example of this heart is like the sky. If the shaitan attempts to go to the sky, or reach the sky, or travel towards it, it will be thrown by flames and meteors. And then he said, and the heart of the believer is more sacred in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the heaven or the sky. And he mentioned the verse in which Allah ta'ala said,
إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٍ.
As for my servants, you have no power over any one of them.
إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّبَعَكَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ.
Except for those who have chosen to follow you from the wrongdoers. So those believers who are close to me, I'll protect them. Those believers who are dedicated to me, I shall grant them protection and guidance. May Allah Ta'ala make us from them. Dear brothers and sisters, let's finish Allah Ta'ala with mentioning few important points that will enable us to have our hearts always purified and close to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. First of all, make sure that we have repentance, a habit in our life. Every time we fall in a sin, we must repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, he said that if the person repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his heart will turn upright, subhanallah. So nothing will enable you to have your heart upright and righteous more than you constantly repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second thing, always fight the sins at the beginning. Always find the sins at the beginning. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahu ta'ala said, the sins begins with thoughts. So repel the thoughts. For if you don't do that, it becomes an idea. So repel the idea. Find the idea. For if you don't, it will become a desire. SubhanAllah. So fight against a desire. Because if you don't do that, it will become a determination and passion. And if you don't repel it, At that stage, it will become an action. You will do it, subhanAllah. And then he said, after that, if you do the action, if you don't stop there and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that action will turn into a habit or a constant habit. And it will become, at that point, very difficult for you to change it. So always try to repel the bad thoughts at the beginning. May Allah ta'ala enable us to do so. Another point that will enable us to have our hearts purified and close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to have a regular portion from the Quran. Reciting the Quran, reading the Quran, because the Quran will make your heart alive, as Allah ta'ala in the Quran said,
وكذلك أوحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا ما كنت تدري ما الكتاب ولا الإيمان.
And we have inspired you, O Muhammad, by a spirit of our command. This Quran. This Quran will make your heart alive. This Quran will fix your heart. This Quran will bring your heart closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah Ta'ala told them, we didn't have any knowledge about the wisdom or the book before our revelation. وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا. We made this Quran a light. نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. With which we guide whomever we want from our servants. May Allah Ta'ala make us from them. And finally, brothers and sisters, make sure that you have a regular portion from remembering Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala daily. The remembrance of Allah Ta'ala will make your heart alive. The remembrance of Allah Ta'ala will grant you the help of Allah Ta'ala, the guidance of Allah Ta'ala, the protection of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, the help from Allah, the Almighty. Allah Ta'ala will be with you. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me, and I shall remember you. Allah Ta'ala will remember you by giving you guidance, giving you help, protection, and enabling you to worship him subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. And be thankful to me and never disbelieve in me. May Allah ta'ala enable us to have our hearts close to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah enable us to have our hearts purified. اللهم أصلح قلوبنا. اللهم أنير قلوبنا. اللهم أعنا على أن نجعل قلوبنا خالصة مخلصة لك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ثبت قلوبنا على طاعتك. اللهم ثبت قلوبنا. اللهم اهد قلوبنا. اللهم أصلح قلوبنا. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.